All right, let's show you this view now of the Occlokne boat ramp in Wakulla County. And yeah, those dark clouds on the horizon might mean it's time to seek shelter just in case there's a thunderstorm in your neighborhood, right?
Right, kind of hazy skies out there, Mike.
It was really bouncing around about 30 or 40 minutes ago as one of those storms got close enough to throw down a bunch of wind. But most of the area seeing those kinds of conditions, clouds, pretty good bet. Showers and storms for some of us started out with the blue sky and sunshine, and then that's a little more like our typical summery day where we have that transition. We don't start with the showers and the storms in the morning. I start with a little more sunshine, then we get those raindrops by the time we get to 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Still moving basically the same way as last week from southwest to northeast, but the overall pattern has been adjusted just a little bit, and it's enough that it kind of shut down the seeing as many of those Gulf of Mexico morning showers and storms, some isolated ones, yeah, but nowhere near the numbers of what we saw last week. But we're certainly seeing more of them by 5 or 6 o'clock in the afternoon on radar. So there's what's been happening over the last hour. Pretty good thunderstorm that was just north of Crawfordville, kind of teased you, got close, and then kind of fell apart. That's just plain old rain for the most part, moving across parts of Tallahassee. And then once you get to about Madison, things start to cut off rather quickly. The heaviest in between, and that's this thunderstorm. So if you headed out Highway 27, right around Caps there, a spot that a lot of folks know as you head down 19 where that runs into 27. Good downpours there. What happened is a couple of boundaries from some earlier showers kind of ran into each other and lifted that stuff up. So right up the middle of Jefferson County, that's your heaviest rainfall over the Big Bend, while South Georgia, some pretty good downpours north side of Valdosta and headed up toward Moody Air Force Base and also exiting the east central parts of Clinch County. That's probably the strongest storm, but it's moving away. And then the farther west you go, another little batch of some plain old rainfall moving through Bainbridge and up toward Camilla and Pelham. Also moving from southwest to northeast. I give this about another 2 hours for these showers and storms to be around, and then they'll taper off. They won't just suddenly end. I think we'll still have a few around till about 9 or 10 o'clock. After that, it's looking like just the plain old muggy stuff. But tomorrow, and you can throw in Wednesday to this too, still looking like the same pattern what we had today. Very close. A little more morning sunshine, just a slight chance for a couple of morning showers, but then a good chance, about 70% that there'll be a shower or a thunderstorm near you at some point during the afternoon or early evening hours. By the time we get to Wednesday, what has changed though, the winds start to come a little more from the southeast and south. We've been stuck in this pattern of southwest winds, so the direction of movement will change a little bit, and maybe it'll feel a little bit different. We might actually see some daytime highs creeping up toward the second half of the week with more of those mid-90s coming back. For now, you can see the dark clouds in the distance looking out over Lake Jackson, courtesy of WeatherSat. Tallahassee down to just 78. Valdosta, however, 87. That's not bad, but that humidity still makes it feel like 96. In between, Thomasville is at 81. So 70s and 80s where we've got the showers. Madison High, Live Oak, Perry, kind of waiting on some rain where it's still at 90 and feels like 100 to 101. Heat indices could be a little more of an issue toward the end of the week. The rain chances will drop only slightly. But this time of year, 60% is about what we typically have. That's what I have for the end of the week. But those highs get back up into the mid-90s. For now, we're looking at some mid-70s to even some low to mid-90s. But once those showers come along, it'll cool things down rather nicely. Still some good news from the tropics, so let's just keep this going. Although I'll say it again, it wouldn't be a bad thing at all to get a couple of storms to develop out here in the middle of the Atlantic and not bother anybody, because the water is still getting toasty warm again. But there is still plenty of dust that's been coming off the African coast, that Saharan air layer. Another big swath of that moving across the Atlantic this week and toward the weekend. Again, these are no big deal. These are not any kind of a threat. I don't think they'll be thick enough to cause air quality issues for us. But what it does is it just keeps the tropics nice and quiet. Nationally, good part of the country, that's a little more like it. Not everyone enjoying that, though. We've got the heat wave high, again, setting up shop out west. So from the southwest up into Montana, they're talking about some extreme heat. For us, the southwesterly flow we've had aloft for more than a week now starts to get weaker and weaker. So by the time we get to the weekend, it's still not one that's just suddenly drier or dry, but it will be just a smidge drier than what we've had. For now, there's just abundant moisture all across the southeastern United States. So the pattern for us still equates to a little more morning sunshine and a good chance for those afternoon showers and storms. Tonight, the storms that are out there right now, give them about another 2 hours. They'll be done for the most part. Some mid to upper 70s to start your Tuesday. And then we're talking some low to perhaps mid 90s, but it's still a good chance, 70% for some showers and storms. And again, Wednesday and Thursday, then we drop those rain chances just a little bit, and wouldn't you know it, the highs get right back up to 92, 93, 94.
I was hoping the 7 day might have like a
some
pot of gold at the end of that rainbow.
Yeah, give us about another month and we can start thinking about that.
Okay, one more month. All right, when we come back, our Ryan Kelly joins us live from the ACC kickoff in Charlotte. Stay with us.